Welcome you all to our online botany classes. Today we'll discuss about sexual reproduction in case of angiosperms. In the previous videos I've explained about asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction in general, and today we'll discuss about how the sexual reproduction takes place in angiosporing plant. It will be a preliminary video on the structure of flower and entire life cycle of an angiosperm plant, and in the following videos I will be explaining about the various events that occur during the sexual reproduction in angiosperm plant. Okay, as far as life cycle of an angiosperm plant is concerned, you know what is life cycle? Starting from its birth to its death, natural death, that the time period between these particular events constitute the life cycle. So life cycle of an angiosperm plant, you know, consists of two phases. What are those? First one is your sporophytic phase, and second one is your gametophytic phase. The sporophytic as well as gametophytic phase, these alternate with each other. Remember, these alternate with each other. The sporophytic phase is dominant, whereas the gametophytic phase is very much reduced. It is true as far as the angiospermic plant is concerned, but when we consider about the lower plants, the gametophytic phase is dominant. In lower plants, the gametophytic phase is dominant, whereas in this case, as far as the angiospermic plant, which are considered as higher plants, the gametophytic phase is very much reduced. Here, sporophytic phase is much more dominant. So, now come to sporophytic phase. Remember that sporophytic phase is always diploid. It is always diploid. It develops from zygote. Thus, zygote is the first cell of sporophytic phase. Zygote is the first cell of sporophytic phase. Why we call it sporophytic phase? Because it produces spores. Okay, as in this phase spores are produced, we call it as sporophytic phase. Now, in higher plants, two types of spores are produced: microspores, which we call as pollen grains in general, and megaspores. Microspores and your megaspore. In case of angiosperm, the entire standing body is a sporophyte. Got it? And the gametophyte is very much reduced, which develops inside the small part of a flower. So, the entire plant that you see is actually the sporophyte in case of your angiosperm plant, and as far as gametophyte is concerned, it is very much reduced and it develops inside the small part of a flower. Okay, now let us come to the next slide. Gametophytic phase. So what is gametophytic phase? It is the haploid phase. Unlike the sporophytic phase, which was diploid, here the gametophytic phase is haploid. It develops from spores, which are the first cell of gametophytic phase. So, the spores are the first cell of gametophytic phase. Got it? Two types of gametophytes are formed: male gametophyte, which are produced from microspores, and the female gametophyte produced from megaspores. The male gametophyte produces male gametes, and the female gametophyte produces female gametes. Remember it, the male gametophyte produces male gamete and the female gametophyte produces female gamete. See here, I have drawn a diagram regarding the life cycle of an angiospermic plant. Well, see, this sporophytic phase, here sporophyte. The sporophyte, you know, the entire plant body, we can call it a sporophyte, the standing plant body. In the sporophyte, there is presence of flower, which is the reproductive part of the plant body. Now, flower has ovary as well as anther. You know, we will discuss about the structure of flower in the next slide. So, flower has ovary as well as anther. Now, ovary bears what? Megaspores. And the anther bears microspores. Got it? Or pollen grains. Or anther develops pollen grains. These pollen grains then later forms male gametophyte, and the male gametophyte gives rise to male gametes. Male gametes, in the mean period of time, the ovary which bears megaspores develop to form female gametophyte, then female gametophyte develops female gametes. The male gametes and the female gametes, male gametes and the female gametes both of them unite in the process of fertilization to form a zygote. Okay, then this zygote develops to form a seed. Then this seed again germinates. When germinates, gives rise to a sporophytic plant. So this is what the life cycle of an angiospermic plant. Now, as far as the two phases of the life cycle are concerned, this one is the sporophytic phase. Sporophytic, and this one is gametophytic phase. Look, I have demarcated gametophytic phase. Okay, I have demarcated it. Got it? So sporophytic phase is denoted by diploid 2n, whereas the gametophytic phase is haploid n. Got it? So this is what as far as life cycle of an angiospermic plant is concerned. Now let us come to the next slide. Structure of a flower. Now, as far as the structure of flower is concerned, more or less you know about it in the first year, isn't it? In the morphology section, you have already studied the different parts of a flower, isn't it? So, let us again revise it. You know, the flower is the reproductive organ of angiosperm. If anybody asks, what is a flower? Now, it is nothing but the reproductive organ of an angiosperm. Got it? The flower consists of four important holes. What are those? Calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium. Calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium. We are slowly entering into the internal structure of flower from outside. Calyx is followed by corolla from outside, then androecium and gynoecium. Got it? So now let's go to the next slide. As far as calyx is concerned, it is the outermost hole. Let me show the picture first. So this one is the calyx. This one is the calyx, this green part. Okay, this one is the calyx. Its individual units are called sepals. Got it? This one is a sepal, this one is a sepal. Then the next hole was corolla. This one is corolla. Got it? So what are the individual units of this corolla are called? The individual units of the corolla are called petals. Got it? Then there are androecium and gynoecium. We will discuss in details about androecium and gynoecium in the next slides. Okay, let us come to the next slide. Calyx. Calyx is the outermost hole and its individual units are sepals. Like I have said, this is the outermost hole and its individual units are sepals. It is the outermost hole and its individual units are sepals. Got it? Now, come to corolla. Corolla is the second hole and its individual units are called petals. I have already told you, corolla is the second hole. This one is corolla. These are petals. Okay, these are petals. Got it? Now come to the next hole, that is androecium. Androecium, it is the male reproductive part and its individual units are called stamens. Androecium is the male reproductive part and its individual units are called stamens. Got it? The stamens consists of anthers and filaments. Now anthers, which are otherwise known as microsporangia, they produce pollen grains, which in scientific term we call as microspores. Got it? Then which ultimately produces male gametophyte. So what is androecium? Androecium is the male reproductive part. Its individual units are called stamens. Like what we had studied about corolla and petals, the combination of petals, corolla. Combination of sepals, calyx. Similarly, combination of stamens we call as androecium, or collection of stamens we call as androecium. Got it? So Stamens are the individual units of androecium. Stamens consists of anthers and filaments. Anthers, which are otherwise known as microsporangia, they produce the pollen grains called microspores, which produce the male gametophyte. The microspores give rise to the male gametophyte. Let me draw a diagram here, a rough diagram. As far as stamens are concerned, okay, this one is stamens. This one is your anther. Got it? And this one is the filament. F-I-L-A-M-E-N-T. Okay? F-I-L-A-M-E-N-T. Filament. Filament. There is another structure which connects the filament with the anther. This one is called connective. Connective. Okay? This one is called connective. Got it? Now let us come to the next hole, that is gynoecium. What is gynoecium? It is the innermost hole. Gynoecium is the innermost hole. Got it? It is the female reproductive part. It is the female reproductive part. Female reproductive part. Androecium was the male reproductive part. Gynoecium is called female reproductive part. Its individual units are called carpels, otherwise called megasporophylls. Individual units of androecium are called stamens, but the individual units of gynoecium are called carpels. Gynoecium otherwise known as pistil. Gynoecium otherwise known as pistil. But individual units of gynoecium are called carpels. Now, carpel, if we look into the structure of an individual carpel, it has got an ovary, swollen ovary at the base, a long style and a stigma at the tip. Got it? The structure looks like this. This. Okay. So, this one is the base. This one is the base. So, base is swollen. It is called ovary. This one is called your style. This one is called stigma. Okay, stigma, style and ovary. Inside the ovary, there are presence of ovules. Ovules, which are otherwise known as megasporangia, within which the embryo sac is formed. So, inside the ovary, there are presence of ovules within which the embryo sac is formed. So, ovary is the structure where ovules are found and ultimately where embryo sac are formed. Got it? So, this is what your structure of gynoecium. Now, structure of flower is concerned, what we had studied, the flower consists of flower is the reproductive part or reproductive organ of the plant body. It consists of calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx is the outermost hole and its individual units are called sepals, like this. And then individual units of corolla are called petals. Then there are presence of androecium. Look at it. Androecium here, this one is called anther, and this one is called filament. Got it? This one is called filament. Another structure called connective is not shown here, but the part where the filament connects with the anther is called connective. Okay. Now, come to the innermost hole, that is the gynoecium. It is the female reproductive part, otherwise known as pistil. Individual units of the gynoecium are called carpels, whereas the individual units of the androecium are called stamens. And as far as carpels are concerned, they consist of a stigma at the tip and an ovary at the base, swollen ovary at the base. Now, in between stigma and ovary, there is a long style. Got it? Now ovules are found inside the ovary, and inside the ovule embryo sac is formed. So this is what somewhat structure of flower. This is the flower structure. Okay, another thing that I would like to mention here, here it is written peduncle, but it is not right. Why? Because peduncle is a term generally associated with the inflorescence axis. Got it? So it should be called as pedicel. Pedicel. Peduncle is wrong. Okay, it should be called as pedicel. It is the stalk of the flower. Pedicel is the stalk of the flower. Remember it. Peduncle is the inflorescence. Inflorescence axis. You don't have to remember that right now. If inflorescence is taught in the previous year, so pedicel, as far as pedicel is concerned, is the stalk of the flower. Okay. So what we had studied today? We had studied about the the different life cycle, the phases of the life cycle in case of your angiosperm plant, the gametophytic phase, sporophytic phase. Then we studied about the structure of the reproductive organ of the flower. Okay. In the next video, I will be discussing about the process of sexual reproduction. First, we will study about the pre-fertilization phase, because we have already studied that in the sexual reproduction three phases are found, that is pre-fertilization, fertilization and post-fertilization phase. So as far as pre-fertilization phase, we will discuss about it in the next video, that too in 2 to 3 sub videos. Okay, thank you.